In the previous video, we learned how to add a logical camera to our factory simulation by modifying the world file in Gazebo. Now, let's learn how to configure a few parameters of the logical camera so that we can make use of the information it provides within our ROS application. So, let's first open up the hrwros.world file where some of the models we use in the factory simulation are already added. And if we scroll down a bit, we will see that we have two models already included in the hrwros.world file, namely the deletion underscore wall model and the conveyor model. Let's look at the conveyor model here. We have a pose tag where the first three entries indicate the 3D position of the camera with respect to a fixed reference frame such as the world. And the last three entries denote the orientation of the camera also with respect to the fixed reference frame world. And there we use Euler 1 conventions of roll, pitch and yaw. And remember, Euler 1 angles or Euler 1 rotations are applied in the yaw, pitch, roll order. Let's not dive into more details of Euler 1 rotation conventions in the context of this course, and we provide you the desired rotations in the assignments, so you just have to add them at the right locations. Alright then, let's go to the models folder where we learned earlier that our logical camera model exists. And a common component of all models in Gazebo are two files, namely model.config and model.sdf. The config files contain administrative information, and we briefly explored the SDF files in the last video. The use of config files for administrative information is just a convention. Let's now dig into the logical camera model.sdf file. So, we see the model has a name, and this name is unique to the logical camera. So, when you add multiple logical cameras, you have to give them different model names. Otherwise, you will not be able to use them properly. Then, we have a plugin specification that simulates the functionality of the logical camera. The details of the plugin itself are not necessary for this course, so let's just use the plugin like the way it has been specified here. Then we have the robot namespace tag. For simplicity, let's just think of this as a prefix to the information that will be provided by the logical camera. For example, if it provides an image on a ROS topic called logical underscore camera, then the topic will appear on the ROS topic list command as slash hrwros slash logical underscore camera. Then we can also configure the logical camera to provide noisy information by specifying position and orientation noise like shown here. But we will not do that in this course. And then we see that the logical camera also has a link name just like any other robot link we have seen so far. And again, this name has to be unique when we configure multiple cameras in our factory simulation. And the last configuration element for the logical camera is the sensor element, which has a name and a type. And yet again, the name should be unique for every logical camera you add in the factory simulation, and this name is also the name of the topic on which the logical camera data will be available. So, remember this for your assignment. The type will still be the same because it is the same type of sensor, but the name will be different because it is a different sensor. Then we have two parameters which decide how close and how far an object can be from the logical camera for the object to be detected. These parameters also decide the size of the camera frustum. We will leave them with the default values. And then we have some optical parameters of the camera, which we will also leave at their default values. Then the last three parameters decide whether we want the camera to be shown in the simulation world, and if it is always kept on, and what is the rate at which the information from the camera will be published. In a minimalistic configuration, we can leave the camera always on so that it keeps publishing information even though there are no objects. However, this can be optimized, and you can read up about the logical camera plugin on Gazebo tutorials if you are interested. Now that we know how to configure the logical camera to give us useful information, let's find out how to access that information in the next video.